In March 1980, at the Geneva Motor Show debut Renault Fuego. The vehicle is called by the company direct ancestor of the Mégane Coupe. As for its time, Fuego characterized by good looks, interesting, and for original style. The name of Fuego is fire in Spanish. For the exterior design, Boss replied Michel Jardin, and a new designer, Robert Opperin, who went straight to the Renault from Citroën, where he designed, among others, Model SM and CX. Contrary to prevailing in the 70s trend of sharp edges and geometric design, Opperin was a supporter of body with soft, flowing lines. Thanks to that, the Fuego was one of their most aerodynamic and slippery car available in the early 80s. With drag coefficient of 0.34. The most characteristic feature of the new design was curved rear window, which is also the boot lid. Inside, the front seats appeared in aviation style. In higher version, there was also available rev counter. The most expensive version of the Fuego passed into history as the world's first mass-produced car opened remotely by infrared remote control. In addition, the top model had power windows, velour, or leather upholstery, power steering, and tinted green glass. The motor of the strongest Fuego used 4-cylinder, with 1.6 liter of capacity. This engine developed 132 horsepower, along with Garrett turbocharger. With all wheels used disc brakes, front even ventilated, the Fuego has great brakes for its times. From the outside of the turbo, stood out aluminum rims from BBS, which was mounted on 185 section tires. Sporty atmosphere of the interior formed, with leather steering wheel, and special seats with colorful accents. In the United States, Fuego Turbo was equipped and offered with catalytic converter, which reduced the power to just 112 horsepower. There were also versions available with the 2.2-liter engine delivers 102 horsepower, powered with fuel injection. The turbo model has developed a top speed of around 200 kilometers per hour, and can crack first 100 kilometers per hour in less than 10 seconds. Production in France ended in July 1985, and offer car remained for the next several months in the Renault sale.
unlike some of the sports casual clothes of the 80s, car designs were also beginning to cross over. One particularly eye-catching sports coupe showed that Renault was rediscovering its confidence in designs that sought attention.
La Renault Fuego a été lancée en 1980. Elle est le fruit du travail de Michel Jardin, un designer de Renault qui travaillait sous les ordres de Robert Aupron.
Qui découpe la voiture avec énormément de simplicité. Et ça, c'est un thème qu'il faut garder.
La Fuego, elle est basée sur la plateforme de la Tressage Renault 18. Et tout le but du jeu était d'en faire un coupé pas tellement sportif, c'était pas ça sa vocation, mais on va dire peut-être un peu plus show-off, un peu moins sage, un peu plus flamboyant que la berline Renault 18.
But I think something like the Renault Fuego is all the rational principles of car design are rather left behind, and something which can become, admittedly it has its vices and its virtues as a product, but it does recognize this idea that a car can be something playful, it can have qualities which are, you know, which cannot be determined entirely, you know, technologically and scientifically.
C'est son aérodynamique. C'était une caractéristique très importante à l'époque, on était après les crises pétrolières. Et on a réussi ici à avoir un CX de 0,34, ce qui était excellent pour l'époque. Deuxième grande caractéristique, ces bandes latérales striées qui vont dynamiser le profil de la voiture. Et puis enfin, troisième caractéristique essentielle, c'est cette bulle arrière, cette immense bulle qui va donner beaucoup de luminosité à l'habitacle et qui va permettre d'avoir une forme de pavillon qui préserve l'habitacle à l'arrière, qui donne de l'espace aux passagers arrière qui vont ainsi pouvoir bénéficier d'un espace agréable pour parcourir de longues distances.
Il y a un petit peu ce côté tricorps allongé, coupé un peu sportif. Et aujourd'hui, ce qui est assez amusant, c'est que la R18 coupée, donc cette voiture-là, la Fuego, c'est une voiture collectionnée. Donc ça prouve qu'elle avait quelque chose, même si à l'époque, elle n'a pas connu un succès extravagant. Mais il y avait un truc.
Renault Fuego invite you to enter the Turbo Zone. Renault Fuego, built with the same passion to perform that turbocharged Formula One. Renault Fuego, priced to move you from the here and now into the Turbo Zone. Fuego Turbo, $11,095. Renault Fuego from $86.95.
Hey! Hey, attendez!
La police.